Let's see how accurate the new ChatGPT is. I got this Word document of difficult questions, and I'm gonna upload this entire thing onto ChatGPT and get it to answer all of them. Here we go. And let me cross-check these with the actual solutions. 18 out of 20, that's not bad. But that is just one of the things that ChatGPT can do. It can also make mind maps, plot graphs, summarize websites, YouTube videos, and much more. Anyways, I've spent hours testing out all the new features, and here are the most useful. So the improved ChatGPT, ChatGPT 4, has a few different modes. And I paid for this so you don't have to, and so watch this video to see if it's actually worth it. But first, there's the default mode, which is just basically more accurate than the free version. So you can do the same things, but better, such as editing essays, explaining concepts, generating practice questions, etc. But the real game changer are the next two modes. So first, there's code interpreter, which sounds fancy. You don't need to know how to code, but it can do a couple of cool things. First, you can upload documents, which you saw in the intro. Now there's this little plus icon, which you can press and select a file. And this works best with Word documents or text files. And so after you upload that file, you can ask questions based on what's inside that document. For example, finding the answers, which you saw in the intro, but more helpful in my opinion is getting it to explain the questions you don't understand, or things like summarizing the document or helping me brainstorm more ideas. Other than this, Code Interpreter is great at maths compared to the old version, because now with code, it can check its answers. For example, let's paste in this question, which is about plotting a graph, and we get something like this. So not bad, the graph is a bit stretched out though, but luckily we can fix this. And basically I got it to zoom in a bit more, which just shows that you can keep giving it feedback and adjusting the answer until you get something you want. The final mode on ChatGPT I found even more helpful, and these are called plugins. And these are basically like little add-ons which allow you to do more specialized things. And there's a whole store for you to pick from. I'm just going to go over the most useful for studying. So first there's a plugin called Whimsical, and this helps us make mind maps. And I'm going to install it and select it. And I can say something like, create a mind map for all the muscles in the human arm based on which nerves they are supplied by. And we get something like this, boom. So looking at this, it does a pretty good job. All the info here I just checked is correct, but it just missed half muscle. So it's not a big deal. We can actually go into this mind map and edit it. Or another way to go about it is when I'm typing out the prompt, be specific about the terms I want included. Next, let's make flashcards in one step using this plugin called Deep Memory. So I'm just gonna say, make a set of flashcards with the following info. Basically, one side has the term that I want, and then the other side has the definition. So let's go. So same as before, the information here is accurate, or at least accurate according to my notes, which are based on ChatGPT. Anyways, like before, it's good to specify all the terms you want to be included, otherwise it sometimes leaves out things. Next plugin is called Video Insights, and this can summarize a full video for you. So I have here a YouTube video on some trigonometry by the amazing Khan Academy. So let's copy the link over and type summarize the video at the URL of, and paste it in. We can also do the same with websites with a plugin called WebPilot. So find the link of the website that you want and paste it in like so. And we can say, what are some key points on this website? And done. Next, if you're doing any research, this plugin, Scholarly AI, allows you to find the relevant scientific papers. So let's say I'm researching the disease HIV. I can say, find research papers on the scientific background of HIV between 2010 and 2023. And also, the links work as well if you click on them. Okay, I was about to upload this video, but ChatGPT actually just got a new update yesterday. And this new feature is called Custom Instructions. And you can activate this by going into the settings, and then you can see there's two text boxes here where you can fill out some extra details. But basically, whatever instructions you write here, ChatGPT will keep these in mind every time it answers any of your questions. The first text box is about some personal information, so you can provide better responses. And then the second text box, you can tell ChatGPT how to respond. For example, the style, the length, or anything else you want it to include. And just to show you the difference that this makes, I'm just going to give ChatGPT the same prompt, but with instructions enabled and disabled. So you can see it's much more detailed and tailored to what I want. So let me know what you found useful, and I'll keep you updated on any changes in the future. And in the meantime, you may like this lazy way of learning 10 times faster.